Hi, and welcome to the first Haltech Q&A for 2018. This is a segment where you guys ask the questions and we give you the answers. Our first question today comes from Crow Forever, and they ask, is it possible for the ECU to control an exhaust cutout butterfly valve? Well, Crow Forever, the answer is yes. Some of these butterfly valves or these exhaust bypass valves are actually available in standard cars. Some of the European cars have them and they bypass some of the mufflers in order to make them quicker or make them sound a lot better. In the Haltech system, we can control these valves using some of our generic output tables. So what we'll do is set up a generic output table that'll go to your valve controller so that when we either press down on our throttle pedal or we reach a certain amount of boost pressure or a certain amount of RPM, it'll then activate the controller. The valve will open in order to get more exhaust flow or more noise out of your car. Our second question today comes from Kirk W, and he asks, what is a piggyback installation? Kirk, this is a really good question and truthfully one that we don't actually get asked that much, but one that I agree is certainly something that we need to talk about. A piggyback ECU installation can be one of two things. So the first one we'll talk about is a signal bender style ECU installation. So that's referred to as the first style of piggyback, and the way that that style of system works is by intercepting the crankshaft sensor so that we can intercept how fast the computer thinks the engine is turning, so if we can speed it up or slow it down by intercepting the crank sensor signal, as well as intercepting or cutting into the load sensor. So that might be the throttle position, the airflow meter, or the manifold pressure. By cutting into that signal, and we feed the sensor into an ECU and then out of the ECU back to a factory computer, we can then adjust how much load the factory computer sees. This way, that's why I call it a signal bender, because we're bending or we're manipulating the factory sensors in order for the factory ECU to see a different load and then give us a different fueling or different ignition value. The second style of piggyback ECU installation, which is a lot more popular, is where we leave the factory computer in place, but we also wire in a full standalone ECU. The full standalone ECU shares all of the sensors with the factory computer. So that would be the crank sensor, the cam sensor, the air temp, the coolant temp, the throttle position, the manifold pressure. So both computers are looking at all of the sensors. We would then cut the injectors and the ignition, maybe the cam control as well, off the factory computer and allow the aftermarket ECU to control those things. So now you'd end up with a factory computer that's got all the sensors going into it, but not controlling fuel and ignition. Whereas the aftermarket ECU would be controlling the injectors, the ignition, and the cam control. The benefit of doing it like this is that we can leave the factory computer there and it might still be controlling all of the dash, it might be doing the air conditioning system, it might be doing a factory automatic transmission. So that way we can share the load between the two ECUs, we can let the Haltech ECU or the aftermarket ECU control the engine and the engine power, or the factory ECU is left there to control the rest of the car. Our last question today comes from Jarmo. Is it possible to do boost by gear on my R32 GTR without adding any extra sensors? Jarmo, the answer is yes. On your R32 GTR, we should have a speed signal going into the ECU, so that way we know our road speed. And you've also got engine RPM because we've got our crank angle sensor coming in. So because we know the road speed and we know the engine RPM, the one thing that we need to enter into the ECU is our gear ratio. That gives us a relationship between the road speed and the engine RPM so that at any time we know what gear you're in. So it's as simple in our ECU, you would cruise, drive along, be on line with the ECU, go into our gear setup, cruise along in first gear, press read. It's that simple. Get into second gear, cruise along at a steady RPM, press read. Do this for each gear that you've got. If you've got an R32 GTR, it's a 5-speed. Once you've done that, apply and okay. From there, whenever you choose a gear, that gear ratio will let the ECU know exactly what gear you're in, so you can then do boost per gear. You can also display that on any of your CAN-based dash systems. Well, that's all the questions we've got today. We're always looking for more questions, so if you've got one you're thinking about right now, leave them in the comments below, jump on our Facebook page, or haltech.com. It's probably the easiest way to get us some questions. When we get them, keep on watching. We'll definitely be answering them in the upcoming videos. My name's Scott. As always, thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.